You're about to witness a video of an elderly lady who no longer recognizes her living room, nor even her own son.
No, I don't know much about where the relations were.
You don't know how you're related to me?
Yeah.
We are home, Mom.
This lady is not just getting old. Her memories are being erased by a disease that's causing her brain to physically wither away and die. Alzheimer's disease. Within a normal, healthy brain, there are cells that pass messages from one area to another. When grandparents speak about the good old days, it is thanks to these cells connecting their memory hub with their centers of speech. If you look closely, you'll see that the message must pass across a small space between each cell. In Alzheimer's patients, this space becomes clogged by an abnormal structure, and communication comes to a halt. Furthermore, the long, thin part of the cell that the message passes across is destroyed from within due to a change in an important protein. This causes the cell to shrivel and die, leaving behind what scientists call a neurofibrillary tangle. The tangle, in conjunction with the plaques that prevent cellular communication, are the two features that define Alzheimer's disease. There are currently no effective treatments for Alzheimer's, though there's one promising frontier: cannabis. Chemicals in cannabis, including THC, are now at the frontier of Alzheimer's research, because they have potential to reduce and prevent the formation of Alzheimer's plaques. If plaque formation can be slowed or halted, as recent studies suggest, and if patients can be diagnosed early enough, then the potential exists to prevent debilitating and lethal forms of Alzheimer's. Cannabidiol, another cannabis chemical, has been found effective in improving symptoms in mouse models of Alzheimer's. A recent Australian study concluded that the mouse model findings could easily be followed up in clinical trials, since CBD is well tolerated by humans. Despite the promising research, however, the news is not all good. In July 2015, a series of media articles reported that cannabis had been proven ineffective in treating Alzheimer's disease. The only problem with the headlines is that they were not true. The study they were referring to was commissioned to determine the safety of THC pills for persons with dementia, as well as other technical data. The conclusion reached was that the pills were safe, and that further human studies with higher doses were warranted. Thankfully, not everyone is fooled by the headlines.
But boy, it's just such a difference now from a half hour ago.
Oh, what was the half hour?
You were pacing back and forth, not believing this was your house, and you had to get out of here.
A half hour ago?
Yes, ma'am. Yep.
Holy hell.